The American Legion Auxiliary proudly honors Leslie Lightfoot as their 2019 Woman of the Year in recognition of her lifetime commitment to men and women veterans in need.
I became interested in the service, I think when I was 9 years old probably. My dad had given me his Purple Heart, and even though I didn't know exactly what it was, I knew it was extremely special to him, and I think that probably set the stage for my future. My childhood friend was killed in Vietnam, and I was going to go avenge his death and save the world, and so I became an Army medic.
Leslie served in emergency rooms at Fort Dix and in intensive care at Landstuhl Regional Medical Center during the Vietnam War. Her experiences prepared her for a lifetime of service for America's veterans.
As an Army medic, I worked emergency room on Fort Dix and then intensive care in Landstuhl. And then when I got out of the Army, as a medic, I don't think you ever feel like you've done enough. So it was just the natural path to keep trying to do for vets. After I got out of the Army, I went back to school. I used my benefits. I got a couple psychology degrees and became board certified as an expert in traumatic stress. So I've done counseling for 40-some years with veterans who've experienced trauma. And I also set up some programs for veterans.
Those programs founded by Leslie are under the umbrella of Veteran Homestead, a not-for-profit agency geared to helping men and women veterans in need.
There are six programs in the Veteran Homestead. The first one was the hospice. Each program is geared to a different problem that a veteran might have. The hospice was designed basically for veterans who were too sick to take care of themselves and didn't have a family and didn't have anybody to change the sheets or care about them. And then as it progressed, we took in the Hero Homestead, which was for mostly for elderly vets, but all the programs combined drug and alcohol treatment, as well as homelessness, and sometimes just guidance is all they needed. The Armistice Homestead was basically drug and alcohol rehabilitation. We have a program in Puerto Rico, the only program for veterans specifically in Puerto Rico, that was for drug and alcohol, but it kind of encompassed everything, homeless veterans as well. Then we started the program in Gardner, which was for veterans coming back from Iraq and Afghanistan who really didn't know how to integrate back into society. We even had active duty veterans come there because they didn't have enough money to live on their own.
NVTRC features beautiful, modern, community-based housing that offers counseling for PTSD, recreation area with a lap pool, workout area, and a physical therapy center available to residents facilitated by volunteer clinicians.
And we had the Veterans Victory Farm in New Hampshire, which taught them, it was really animal therapy because animals are so good for people who really can't relate to another person, but you can tell that donkey anything and he will never repeat it. So that worked out very well. They grew vegetables and sold them. It was a working farm.
Leslie's children have followed in her footsteps of military service.
I have three children who are in the military. I have a daughter who's a lieutenant colonel in the Army right now. I have an Air Force daughter who teaches loadmasters, and I have a son who's an Iraq and Afghanistan veteran who has come home with a minor head injury. I'm retired now. I spend my time living in the Bahamas and fishing and spearing lobsters, so that's all good. And the DAV is taking over the programs. They're going to run them the way they were intended to help veterans. It's so exciting. I could not be more thrilled that they're doing it.
Leslie has a message to all ALA members.
Just remember this. If I can do this, anybody can do it. And the bottom line is just get out there and help a vet. No matter what it is, just go do it.
Thank you, Leslie Lightfoot, for your lifetime of dedicated service to our men and women veterans.